Good afternoon, my name is Mr. Kaz of the Recreation Department. Today I'll be going over cooking. And today I'll be cooking grilled pork chops, wild rice, collard greens, and here's all the materials laid out for me to start my job. Why is it important? It is important to get nutritious food in your body. How does it relate to everyday life? Everyday life, you need to eat. So let's begin. I want to clean my collard greens in cold water. So let's go. Put them out there. I'm laying them in the sink. Definitely have to clean your collard greens or any type of vegetables really good. So that's part of the process of starting our collard greens, cleaning them first. And I'll be cleaning them by the cold water several times. Let them soak a little bit. Now I want to put some apple cider vinegar in there. Kill anything. Give it a little flavor too, after, you know, cleaning it. Now I want to take the stems off and just use the leaves. This is what I like to do. I just like to take all the stems off and fold it up and use the leaf. So, what I'll be doing. Cutting it off. Like so. That's my dog, no patience. So, it's a little consuming process, but that's the way I like to eat my collard greens and prepare them. Again, you ask me why I'm doing this, because I don't like the stem, just the leaf itself. Some people prefer to keep the stem and cook it in there. Almost there. Almost there, people.
Wait.
To the next stage. cut. This is garbage. You like to keep a clean work area when you're cooking. Organization. So now, what I will be doing is placing a few of these leaves together. And I roll it up. Roll it up like so. Make small slices. Gonna make some eggs, of course. Sorry. So I'm gonna put it in here, strainer. Once I finished, didn't have that, so I wasn't totally prepared. Apologize. So we're gonna do this process again. Get a few leaves together. Careful with the knife. As we go again, same thing. Get a few, roll it up. Depends on how you want it, slices, small slices. You gotta have patience to cook, because preparing meals is tedious work. So I appreciate the mothers, fathers. It takes time to work all day and come and cook the home cooked meal. It's not always easy. Same procedure. Take the rest of these so we can be done with it. Try to get station. I ain't got no jokes for you today. I'm all business. Again, slice it up. Don't get lazy. Finish that part. Then I'm gonna rinse it off again. Cold water, of course. Bring it up. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put these in this pot right here. Put it on the stove. I have my pots already lined up. Turn my stove on. I'm gonna keep it at high right now. I'll turn it down. Nice and clean, nice and fresh greens. Definitely my favorite vegetable. So I got the pot on. It's supposed to be a really good avocado oil, a good substitute for regular different oils. So my wife got me on a little health kit. Why do I put that in there? Little flavor so the pot don't stick. Let me put that back. I want to cut up an onion. Because I like to put onions in my collard greens. Why do you do this? Flavor. Flavor. That's why. So I'm cutting some onions up to put in my collard greens. And I'm going to take my smoked turkey necks and put about 2 or 3 in there and let it cook right into the, with the collard greens. So let's begin. My water's boiling. Oh yeah, of course. I want to put a little seasoning with my collard greens. First thing first. Couple turkey necks. Wash them off. This is for the flavor as well. Adobo, put it right in there. Now we'll put our collard greens in. Yeah. bit more water. That's fine. Put these back in the refrigerator, don't need that no more. Cut my onions up. Put it right in. Let that cook a little bit, and we'll season it some more, give it some good taste. Let it soak, and the preparation of collard greens, we'll let that last for about an hour. Gotta really cook it well. Gotta cook that well. Should have used a bigger pot, but oh well, no problem. Next thing, again, clean up what you don't. To finish with and the garnish. Now we're going to clean the pork chops. Cold water. I'm just gonna take off what I don't want on here. I'm taking some of the fat off and clean it off. Cutting little fat pieces off that I don't want. That's fine. Again. Taking off some of the stuff that I don't like on there. Nice. Pieces. Again, taking off some of this. Right? See? That I don't want on. Like so. Do this on the side. Like put it back in. We don't need this. Now I'm here to tenderize my meat. Pork chop. It's called tenderizing. I guess we'll use this. Again, we're tenderizing the pork chop. Both sides. Again. And we're going to grill these. Season them and grill them. So now we'll season it. I usually marinate these as well, but not today. Simple seasoning. So I'm not going to overdo it. Going into my seasonings. The garlic powder. So I got garlic powder, onion powder, black pepper, Lowry's. I want to put this red crushed peppers and adobo, and that with a little bit of garlic. Quick tap, coming back. Quick tap, coming back. I'm going to use the Lowry seasoning salt. Not too much, but enough. smoke. Just a little bit. Comes out a lot. Give it a little flavor. Same thing on the other side. What you do on the front, you do on the back. You dry the meat off so it can take. Go with the garlic. Season it. Coming back. Fire. Onion powder. Pepper. Don't have to go in no special order. Just whatever I grab, I put on. You know? So I put it over there. Go with the Lowry. Smoking rub. Because we're going to put it on the grill, so. Good. Finish with that. Let's go to checking my colleagues in. Collard greens takes a long time. Got a long way to go for that. Want to get a towel. Oops. So it could cook a little bit. Now we're going to prepare some rice. I have the measuring cup. I have the rice right here. Turn the stove on. I'm going to keep it on low for now. Got my meat ready to go. Don't do that. We'll use that still. Let's get some oil. Just a little bit. I got some butter. Supposed to be good, healthy butter for you. Look at it. Kerrygold Pure Irish Butter. Grass-fed butter. Everything we do, trying to start is healthy. I'm going to turn down the pot. Collard greens, because when I put the top on, it's like a volcano is erupting. So what I want to do here now is put my water in, get my water in. Again, why I'm putting this in? so it don't stick to the pan and give a little flavor. Helps it. Rice cook a little better. Now we'll turn it up. So everything is pretty good. Long way to go. In here. Let it boil a little bit. So again, as we started out, we laid all our materials that we needed to prepare our meal there. So I'm just trying to go on some type of order, some type of organization as far as cooking. The meat takes not long at all. Collard greens will take the longest, the rice not too long, and we'll have a well home cooked meal. Out here grilling the pork chops. I got the Pam spray. Original. Put the spray on the grill. So the meat don't stick. Turning the grill on. Yep. Grill is on. Come bring my stuff out. To grill my pork chop. Pork chops on the grill. Take my onions. Let them cook, let them grill onions. A little windy out here in the backyard. Cleaning up as again, clean up as usual. When I'm finished with something, I'm gonna clean up, give myself less to do. Let these grill a little bit. check on one of you. Come over just to see how they going. Okay, flip them back over again, but it's cooking really nice. Right on the open fire. So what I wanna do now is I wanna glaze it. I'm gonna glaze with some, my own original recipe, my secret recipe, both of them. And why I wanna do it now, because I wanna glaze it now, get that flavor in, flip it over and let it cook into it. So my first flip was to glaze the chops. Like so. Little combination. Now we let it cook again. And I flip it back open. After the hard preparation of this meal is finally done, bon appetit. Real pork chops, wild rice, collard greens. Thank you for your time and have a blessed day. Bye.